There was another violent assault, or I guess you could call it that, over the weekend, actually, when Trump was in North Korea. So the president, after his G20 summit in Japan, went up to the demilitarized zone between South Korea and North Korea. He met with South Korean President Moon, and then eventually, which was a surprise to many, he met with Kim Jong-un for the first time since that failed nuclear summit in Vietnam. Now, in a historic moment, Trump crossed over the demilitarized zone line into North Korea, becoming the first sitting US president to do so. He then held a bilateral press meeting with Kim Jong-un, who, of course, very rarely speaks to the press, and if he does, it is almost never in a live situation like this. So while they were trying to get people into this bilateral meeting, into this press gaggle, the US TV pool was trying to get in to the room, and they were being blocked by North Korean security guards. Now, I'm sure you've read a lot of stories about North Korea and their security. They are people that you do not want to mess with because they will file trumped-up charges against you, put you in prison, torture you, and possibly kill you. We saw what happened to Otto Warmbier when he was accused of stealing a propaganda poster in North Korea, and it was a horrible situation. So these are people that you really want to be extremely careful around, and you know, if it were me, I would never go to North Korea in the first place. I have no reason to be there. I'm not even risking it. But Trump, of course, engaging in diplomacy. The US press is trying to get in there. The North Korean security is blocking them. And the brand new press secretary, Stephanie Grisham, who used to be the communications director for First Lady Melania Trump, did something pretty incredible. She actually pushed aside the North Korean security and ushered the US press to go in to the event. Please watch this crazy badass video.
Hey,
So watch how she pushes him aside and she says, go, go, go to the press, ensuring that they have access to this historic press conference between Trump and Kim Jong-un. She deserves huge credit for this. I spoke to a former White House press secretary, Ari Fleischer, who told me that she went above and beyond the call of duty and that he hopes this is a first step toward thawing relations between the White House press secretary and the rest of the press corps, who has routinely complained about access to this White House. She really did a great job here. I know some people have criticized her, saying that it was perhaps inappropriate to physically move these people out of the way. But when you're dealing with a rogue regime like North Korea, whose security won't listen to reason in terms of press access, I think she absolutely did the right thing. She reportedly came out of this with some bruises. She was slightly injured by the event. So huge props to her.